The F-150 has been the biggest selling pickup truck for decades. Ford raised a lot of eyebrows when they announced that the 2015 model would have an all-aluminum body. The Institute has put the new pickup truck through its paces, from low-speed crash tests to higher-speed tests of front, side, rear, and rollover crash protection. The crew cab, the largest selling variant of the F-150, aced all 5 Institute crash tests, including our new front small overlap crash. The results definitively answer the question of whether or not aluminum body can offer the same level of protection as a steel body. The F-150 crew cab qualifies for an Institute top safety pick. The Institute also tested the extended cab version of the F-150. Like the crew cab, it did very well in our moderate front, our side crash test, and our roof strength test, and our rear crash test. However, it floundered in the new front small overlap crash test. The crew cab has extra frame components that help it in this test, and these components are not present on the extended cab version. In the front small overlap crash test of the extended cab F-150, the tow pan and pedals moved nearly a foot back towards the dummy's legs. Steering column moved 8 inches towards his chest, coming dangerously close. The head barely contacted the airbag, slid off, and impacted against the instrument panel. Ford has told us that they're studying the possibility of making changes to the extended cab F-150 to improve its front small overlap crash protection. Because the F-150 is a unique vehicle with its aluminum body, we also wanted to look at repair costs in more common low-speed crashes. Damage to aluminum panels can be more complicated to repair and therefore sometimes more expensive. To assess damageability and repair costs, we ran 2 tests at 10 miles per hour. First, we ran the front of the new aluminum F-150 into the back of the 2014 model steel-bodied one. Then we reversed the test, running the front of the steel-bodied 2014 model into the back of the new aluminum one. Total repair costs for front and rear damage combined were 26% higher for the new aluminum-bodied F-150 compared with its steel-bodied predecessor. The use of aluminum in auto bodies is likely to increase as automakers try to reduce weight to meet fuel economy targets. Our tests show that these vehicles can be just as safe as those with steel bodies.